Okay, we're here today just to give you a very quick lesson in how the ministers of propaganda in the White House are working. They know that they have to control the message. They know that the crafting the message and how you get it out there is the key to the ball game, the key to the ball game. So they've hired, with me, let's do it.
Hi, I'm Linda Douglas. I'm the communications director for the White House Office of Health Reform.
She's Linda Douglas. Do you know who Linda Douglas was? I bet you don't know. You know that she's with ABC News and the highest of the highest ivory towers there with Peter Jennings, that lovely pro-jihadist, she was the congressional correspondent. I mean, talk about being hooked in. Is there any talk about collusion here? You have an ABC correspondent now working for the White House in media. You think she, like, uses her old contacts at all? Nah, they have too much integrity for that.
And one of my jobs is to keep track of all the disinformation that's out there about health insurance reform. And
now, one of my jobs is to keep track of the disinformation. You're going to notice that on words that she wants to club you with, she says disinformation, emphasis, misinformation, emphasis, a lot. Now, when you're listening, I want you to listen with this clue that I just gave you, because it is a psyop. Listen up, with her fancy little, I put my little newscaster suit on today. I got my little newscaster, so we're going to be legit.
And one of my jobs is to keep track of all the disinformation that's out there about health insurance reform. And there are a lot of very deceiving headlines out there right now, such as this one. Take a look at this one. This one says, uncovered video. Obama explains how his health care plan will eliminate private insurance. Well, nothing's
busted.
Could be farther from the truth.
Nothing could be farther than the truth. When you hear that, run. I'm seriously, run for your lives. The people that try and scare people. Who's trying to scare who? I just want to say something. I don't know if you remember during the Bush administration, there are problems with Social Security. I'm sure you know there are problems with Social Security, yes? So what he wanted to do is he wanted to allocate a small portion and give it back to the people. Remember that? Give it back to the people. They would control it. I think 10%, they could do whatever they want with it. They could invest in stocks. They could invest in gold. They could keep it in the bank. They could buy treasuries. They could buy escrow to maturity, triple A rated bonds. The Democrats went nuts. Oh my God, it's terrible, such change. We can't give the people any control of their own money. Are you insane? It was voted down. They talk about a massive change like that. It wasn't massive. It was giving the people back what they earned. This is a complete rout, and they started calling it, I don't know if you noticed this too, more of the PSYOP. 2 weeks ago, they started calling it reform. It is not reform. It is a routing of the healthcare system. Let's keep going with our little new ministry of propaganda.
You know, the people who always try to scare people whenever you try to bring them health insurance reform are at it again, and they're taking...
At it again, fighting free speech. Those pains in the asses are at it again.
At it again. And they're taking sentences and phrases out of context and cobbling them together to leave a very false impression.
But what should we do? Should we hang up the whole 1,500-page nightmare that is the health care bill? We're parsing. We're taking out, look, page 425. That's where they say there's euthanasia.
To leave a very false impression.
False impression. We have a false impression for a president. That's okay.
A false impression. The truth is that the president has been talking to the American people.
I have to tell you, the truth is the president has been talking to the American people. Never. He is incapable of talking to the American people. He holds them in complete contempt.
A lot about health insurance reform and what is at stake for them.
So what happens? Oh yeah, what is at stake for them? A stake in the old heart!
What happens is that because he's talking to the American people so much, there are people out there with a computer and a lot of free time.
A computer and a lot of free time. You mean like you? Believe me, we don't have a lot of free time. We'd rather be out dancing. I know I would. We're trying to save the country, but we're getting in the way of, you know, the great conspiracy against America. Too much time. That was rich.
They take a phrase here and there. They simply cherry pick and put it together and make it sound like he's saying something that he didn't really say.
Oh, you mean like cropping the boy who is holding a sign and calling it a Nazi salute? Is that what she's talking about? Is she talking about the SEIU goons beating up a black conservative? at one of these rallies, these town hall meetings? Is that what she's talking about?
My commitment is to make sure that we've got universal health care. I would hope that we set up a system that allows those who can't go through their employer to access a federal system or a state pool of some sort. There's going to be potentially some transition process. I can envision a decade out or 15 years out or 20 years out.
You know, there were all kinds of myths and smears that were used against then-Senator Obama during the campaign. What we discovered is if we countered them with the real facts, people
thought
it was important to stop that in the
track. That is not his current plan. And so you can say, well, this representative perhaps suggested that this is his position now. But apparently he had a different position when he was a senator, and that's legitimate.
He didn't have a different position when he was a senator. But the point is the president...
I think is a important tool to discipline insurance companies.
Discipline insurance companies. Can we discipline the federal government? How about disciplining the federal government? I want to say something. We want to give health care to a government that, A, I won't even go into cash for clunkers. It's a success. People are willing to take $4,500 for a worthless item. It's successful, but man, that, how about the U.S. Postal Service? A monopoly, can't have any competition, nobody else can deliver the mail. And they've been losing money, bleeding money for how many years? You're gonna let the federal government that has made a mess of every single program. We are in dire straits now because of the federal government. And you think giving them more of your money? I don't know about you, but New York is looking at 57%. You know what galls me? What galls me is 57% tax rate. I have to pay an enormous amount, and every day I find myself fighting the very thing I'm paying for. Do you find that? Like, now we really have to get involved. Grandma and grandpa, they're going down. New business owners, they're going down. Small business owners, they're going down. To fight what we're handing over our blood money to. Do you see how ironic that is?
What we've said is, under our proposal, let's have a system the same way that federal employees do, same way that members of Congress do, where...
Yeah, but the federal employees don't have it. They don't have to sign up for it. And his union thugs, SEIU and ACORN, they don't have to take this plan. It's for everybody else, the real American, the real hardworking American, the people that are driving the motor of this country. Sick of Really? How could we do that? He never says anything. He just keeps talking.
Be farther from the truth. You know, the people who always try to scare people whenever you try to bring them health insurance reform are at it again, and they're taking sentences and phrases out of context and cobbling them together to leave a very false impression. The truth is that the president has been talking to the American people a lot about health insurance reform and what is at stake for them. So what happens...